In coming-of-age films, there's typically one finalizing moment where the heroine realizes that her future is before her and that she can do anything. Maybe it's overcoming an enemy in some heroic battle, or maybe it's telling someone how she feels about them. It's always some moment of grandeur. But the real world is not like that at all. In fact, it's usually a small, seemingly insignificant moment that nudges people out the door into adulthood. I am no exception to this reality. On August 21st, I was awoken by my blaring alarm. I bolted up in panic and threw my phone in fear of the horrendous sound. When it continued to beep, I leapt from the pullout couch and silenced it like any human being would by hitting the snooze button. I gazed out the window. It was still dark. Perfect. I checked my watch. 4:30 a.m. I had exactly 1 hour and 4 minutes until the sunrise. I had a little over an hour to wake up my sleeping sister Quinn, get dressed, drive down the road, and hike up to Lookout Point to watch the sun come up. I looked down at Quinn, seeing that the incessant beeping had frightened her awake. We both stretched and began our preparations. 4:34. Time was moving quickly. As we pulled away from the cabin overlooking the lake, I checked the car's digital clock. 4:50. We drove down the dirt road, slowly through the thick fog, keeping our eyes open for weird animals that might be scurrying to their daytime havens. We held whispered conversations, despite the fact that we were in a car and no one was going to hear us talking. It seemed to be the safest option. We drove through our summer camp, praying that we wouldn't wake anyone up. We arrived at the trail. Quinn checked the time. 4:59. We were running out of time. Tentatively, we trekked up the hill. The walk was short, but when all you can hear is the sound of your own breathing and the eerie sounds of the alive but still forest, it could seem infinite. We came to the base of the rocks. We'd known we'd have to climb it. It was easy enough, but we hadn't factored in the variable of not being able to see. Before starting my ascent, I checked my watch. 5:21. We came to the top and the view was incredible. Gazing over the beautiful mountains, seeing the dark skies in front of us, realizing that the sun was behind us and would be obscured by a wall of tall pine trees when it arrived. Obviously annoyed at this and at ourselves for not realizing this very small yet crucial detail, we considered our options. 5:26. Then we heard an unidentifiable sound. Imagining everything from bears to serial killers, we clutched each other in panic, not daring to make a sound. I mean, in reality, it was probably a bird or something, but all rationality tends to escape you when it's completely alone on top of a mountain. I, feigning a sense of calm, said it was probably nothing, and that maybe we could walk down a trail to a point where the sunrise would be visible, and coincidentally would be away from the sound. My sister, holding back fearful tears, agreed that this would be the best option, you know, for the sake of visibility. We trotted down the last trail, slipping on dew-covered pine needles, fighting against gravity. We arrived to the point which overlooked the boy side of the camp, facing the sunrise, and were greeted by a rainbow of color spanning across the sky. A cloud over the lake furled and unfurled, undulated and contorted into mystical shapes, like some creature waking from its slumber. It was the most beautiful thing I'd ever seen. I checked my watch one last time. 5:32. My sister grabbed my hand softly, and suddenly I was overwhelmed. This moment was the start of my last day of summer, my last day of childhood. I'd be leaving for college in less than 72 hours. This adventure would be my last before crossing the threshold into adulthood. And I was here, at the place where I spent my childhood summers, with my sister, the sole person who'd ever really been there for me, the only constant in this time of change. The sun came fully into the sky, we walked back down to the car, and as we drove away from camp, I smiled to myself, satisfied with how my summer, how my childhood had just ended, with the promise of new horizons and new adventures.